from the Code City, and today we will be integrating we will be integrating Crashlytics in our Android app. So first of all, we need a Fabric account because Crashlytics is provided by Fabric. So go to fabric.io. Now click on Get Fabric and just write your details. Enter the email that you use, because they will send a confirmation email. And after you have confirmed, you will get some options like, let me show you. Let's go to fabric.io. I'm not signing up because I already have a Fabric account. So I'll just log in. Alright, so these are the options that you will get. As of now, we are creating Android app, so we will click on Android. So this is our sign up step. Now we need to install Fabric plugin in our Android Studio. So leave it as it is now and open up your Android Studio. Let me create a new project, as I don't want to integrate Crashlytics in this project. So create a new project, let's just say Crash Report app, and I'll just write the codecity.com. Okay, do this. All right, just click next. We don't need an activity. Let's create an empty activities, because that way we'll have to do less work. Okay, so it is finished. Now you don't need to do this step if you already have a project and you want to integrate Crashlytics in your project that is already open. Just open your project that in which you want to integrate Crashlytics. Let this build. Okay, so I'm missing this thing. I'll leave it as it is. We don't need this now. I'll show you how to integrate Fabric, how download Fabric plugin. So go to settings, click on plugins, and just search for Fabric. Alright, search in repositories. Now click install. Now this is downloading Fabric for Android Studio. This way it will be installed to Android Studio, and you will be able to easily add Crashlytics and all the other tools provided by Fabric to any of your project very easily. Let this finish downloading. Alright, so now just click on restart Android Studio and we will be ready to roll. Alright, let this restart. Okay, it's not restarting by itself. Okay, let's click on restart. Alright, so once Android Studio is restarted, you will be able to see this blue icon. Now this is Fabric, so click on it and click on this power button. See, I'm able to see my organization name. You will be able to see what your organization name that you had put in while registering, while signing up. Just click on next. Now you should be able to see the list of kits that Fabric provides. There's a lot of kits, but now we are focused on Crashlytics, so let us just finish checking. Sorry. Alright, so now it is ready. Just click on Crashlytics. Now you are able to see this Forza crash and user information. You can check this if you want. It's just a mock-up of how you can generate a crash to check if Crashlytics is working properly or not. Just click on install. Now what this install does is, it makes the following changes. it adds these dependencies, these Maven URLs, and this plugin. You can do this manually, but let's click on apply and it will be done automatically for you. Alright, so now you can minimize this, and if you go to your app, you'll be able to see these things are added, and these were not here on the first page. So just click on sync now. Once the app, once your syncing is complete, you should run this app somewhere in the emulator or in a real device, so that you'll be able to see the changes and see your app registered in here. So let's run it. I've already run it. I'm just waiting for it to finish running on my phone. Alright. So our app is running in my phone. Now we didn't have to create any activity or any layouts, as we had selected show this main activity by default. So this is the default page of, if you select add an activity. So now if you go to this thing and then we reload, we should be able to see our app that is registered. You just click on this go to dashboard. Now we can see that we have this crash report app. This is the name of our app, and there are no errors at the moment. Alright, what is this real time analytics? Just click I have read and accept the Fabric analytics terms, as it will allow real time crash analytics. Now there are no errors at the moment. This is the logo that we are using. No errors at the moment, but let's generate an error. Let's just add a button, okay, add a button, a button, and now just let's just do a button dot set on click listener, new on click listener, and just do nothing here. Alright, now we just need to run our app, and just click on the run button, or the shortcut is shift F10. Let it run. It should crash after the app starts itself, as we have not referenced any button to this A button. Okay, so my app has started and crashed in my phone, as I think we can see that in the log. As we can see, the error is null pointer exception, and invoke virtual method set on click listener on null object reference on main activity line 19. So this is the error. Now we can see in Fabric. Let's see what happens. Now this shouldn't take this long. I am not sure what the issue is. Maybe I'll just open another tab. Search for our app. Okay, so there is some problem with their site, I think, because in this new loaded we can see this main activity.java line 19, we can already see the crash here, and so it's pretty fast. It's in real time. You get an email as soon as there is a crash, and there are a lot of analytics. You can see the device is Xiaomi, operating system is 7, and free space was this much when the device crashed, when the app crashed, and the available RAM was 2.42 gigabytes when the app crashed. So there are a lot of details. You can see a lot of details. You can check the raw error, and it's the same thing that we saw in log file, in logcat. All right, so this is it. This is how you can integrate Crashlytics in your Android app. Now this is just one device now, and one crash. In a real published app, there are a lot of crashes and a lot of devices, so this analytics tool is really helpful. Okay, so that's all for today. It's pretty simple, and if you have any problem, just write down in the comment section below. Thanks for joining me again, and if this video helped you, click like and subscribe. Thank you. See you in the next video.